expertise is one thing, structuring, that is also another big expertise. And the third one, networking, is I think where you begin with. So, of course, Dhruva is there, but Sunil, you also have many years of experience and your own clientele. But tell me just one thing, looking at the investment banking space at the present time, where most of the big corporates have their in-house investment banking team, the foreign, you know, banks themselves, the well-established ones, are themselves finding it difficult to get plump deals at this point and businesses at this point. So how are you going to really create a niche and get a business here?
So, look, our focus area, as I said, to start with would be M&A, advisory and restructuring. We think we bring as a composition of deep understanding of the restructuring and structuring ability, understanding of the capital market, and understanding of the various sectors, particularly the new economic sectors. We bring in a very compelling, very value proposition in front of our client. And I think while you're right that some large business houses, they have their own investment banking team, but at the same time, there is a lot of work being done by the investment banks as well. And we think we can play in that space, and we will have a very compelling value proposition.
I just add something there, because you mentioned about in-house, and I think that's quite an interesting question. If you look at lawyers, today we find interestingly that large corporates have their in-house counsels who really do a lot of work. If you look at taxes, there are large houses having their own in-house tax. What that means is that if you are a tax service provider, a legal service provider, an investment bank, you really have to be at a cutting edge to be able to add value beyond what you are talking. I say this very fashionably to say that if my client wants to construct a 25-storied building, when I walk in, he's already on the 22nd story and he's saying, can you help me reach the 25th? I can't begin from base zero. We are confident of our capabilities in this regard, and therefore we believe we supplement, not compete with the in-house teams.
All right. So you'll supplement there, and that could be a very good area to be in. But which is the category that you're looking at? Large caps, mid caps, pipe? You know, what is the ticket size that you will really be going after to get your business?
So if you look at our client base, we actually play in two areas, which is the large companies, because this is where the niches and my relationships are on the large company, but a very large base of mid-cap, which is where Dhruva's own capability is, their own client coverages. So we are going to focus on, while we will focus on the large cap, we will also concentrate a lot on the mid cap as well. There is one area which we definitely want to focus on, and we have already started working on this, is the new technology area. In terms of the changes which are happening, the technology is bringing the changes, for example, fintech and the payments and disruptive technologies, etc. So that's the area which is a big focus for us. Restructuring is the another area which I wanted to talk about.
Delve more into that.
Because of leverage, there are a lot of sectors going through, some sectors are going through a bit of pain, and restructuring of those assets is required to happen.
I want to take that for a point forward. You know, a lot is happening when it comes to the debt situation in the country, and I think for the next 2 years most of the deals are going to come from this particular space. Very few investment banking firms have the wherewithal to deal with this. Do you think you're better positioned here, and how will you take the competition forward here?
And I think the answer has to be yes, because as we spoke about the when you look at IBC, for example, and you look at, we are really looking at structures which help people get out of the debt conundrum. And I can, without getting specifics into clients, as advisors, for example, we as Dhruva are working with several people who are making acquisitions on the NPA list, which has been brought out by the Reserve Bank of India. And you'll be surprised as to how many issues arise there and issues which are unresolved. You speak of a debt waiver, and the next thing which comes to mind is, if you write back debt, what happens to your MAT tax liability? Are you going to end up paying a 20% tax? And that makes everything unworkable. Now, your ability to come back and say, here is a debt which needs restructuring, here is a need to find an alternate buyer. Mm. And then to present that buyer with a structuring proposition which makes it work is something which is very, very critical.
Oh, yes. In fact, we've seen many deals fall because of the structuring issues and also the regulatory hurdles.
Particularly so in IBC space. So you're asking a question about restructuring, and that's the point Sunil was making, that a lot of pain exists in the system. That pain needs to be overcome. I'm glad that the Reserve Bank has gone down the path that it has in terms of identifying, making public the names, and there are the IBC having a time frame within which things need to happen.
Yeah.
That's where the deal-making together with the regulatory becomes very, very important.
Are you a little late in entering this? Because you just launched and the processes have just already started. The expression of interests are already coming in. So has the work been done? And what is your strategy going to be? Because some firms are very clear that they want to back with the seller.
Yeah.
And some want to bring in a buyer wherever they have an expertise. So that's a clear strategy and the choice that some of the investment banking firms are making. What is your strategy here, and has a lot of work been already done?
Yeah. My sense is IBC-related work had just begun. There is a long list and there is a lot of stress in a couple of sectors, right? In terms of the strategy, it would depend from case to case. There can't be one uniform strategy.
Right.
But more importantly, as Dinesh described, the combination which we bring, which is our ability to structure, understand the financials, which is understand the leverage,
mm-hmm.
understand the sector,
yes.
understand the capital market. Because
yes.
most of these assets will have
yes.
to find a new house. And that's where our sector expertise comes in, because as to who the potential buyer would be,
yes.
And how can we restructure, what is the right leverage level for this asset,
mm-hmm.
how could you negotiate with the banks and the lender,
mm-hmm.
And then make this asset viable and repackage and sell it.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the strategy, that's the expertise we bring on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, as you mentioned, Nisha, I think some banks are ahead of us, but the beginning, there's a long list, and
yes.
there's a lot of work to happen there.
Just two lists are out, and there are
yes.
probably
a lot of
a dozen more to go.
Yes,
yeah.
And you're more on the buyer side, Sunil, on this one? You're pitching in with the buyers?
Yes.
Yeah, as I said, it'll be on asset-to-asset basis, but yes, you're right. I don't
think there's a need to really categorize yourself to say we'll act only for...
No, I just wanted to know.
But generally, thus far, we have been on the buyer side. And, you know, to the point which Sunil made, negotiating with lenders
yes.
when you're dealing with buyers who are as sophisticated, who already are into that sector. So if you're looking, for example, at a steel asset, and somebody who's going to acquire is going to be somebody who's already in that industry.
Yeah.
Probably there's an in-house expertise which exists there, but there's a lot beyond that which is required to be there, and that's yes. where we come in.
All right. So you're really spotting that niche where you can create your space, and all the best for that one. But another area that I wanted to also discuss, Sunil, you also were mentioning about the sectoral expertise. FinTech is one area. Avendus has been doing a great job there. Many have tried to build there, but there are very few talent available in the market is what I gather. How are you going to break that particular space?
See, the whole payment space, and therefore the fintech which is connected with payment, is going to go through a paradigm shift, a big change happening because of digitization and the volume which is increasing.
Yeah.
The broad number, if I give you, typically the payment which goes through the system has a 7 times multiplier of GDP. So if our GDP, if we expect to become $6 trillion in 10 years from now, the overall payment space would be $42 trillion, right? That's a very large sum of money.
Mm.
And if that's the case, there is a lot of opportunity which will happen in terms of the front end, the back end, the technology company, the players who are playing in that. And I've been a FIG banker, so I understand that space, and we definitely want to focus on them.
Which are the sectors?
So just to supplement that point, really, is, you know, when you mention about somebody else being in the space, I don't think if anybody starts with a proposition that you are out there to compete with somebody who's existing, that's the right approach. The idea is really, what's your niche? What do you bring differently to the table? And how do you do that?
The pie is big enough.
Absolutely big enough. You know, so
right.
you spoke about Avendus, and it's a firm we hugely admire. They've done some very pioneering work. I don't think the idea is to really go out and compete with them, but the idea is really to say, there are so many more things that one can do. How does one do that?
Right. And which are the sectors that you're prominently looking at apart from the IBC space?
So to start with, we will be, I mean, look, I have done 25 years of investment banking. My team has a number of years of experience. So to start with, we'll be sector agnostic. We'll focus on multiple sectors. Mm. However, we do think that some sectors will require a different kind of strategy and will grow faster, particularly the new technology sectors. So we will have a different focus for them.